Hey everybody, it's Sami here from the Perot Museum of Nature and Science. And in honor of Earth Day this week, I thought that we could do some experiments at home all about climate change, which is a pretty complex process because some of these changes are hard for us to actually see happening.
So we're only going to focus on one variable today that affects climate change, and that's increasing carbon dioxide, or CO2, in the atmosphere.
And then the symptom of that variable of climate change that we're going to do our experiments on is ocean acidification.
We're interacting with carbon dioxide all the time. It's what our lungs exhale, what our car exhausts produce, and it's what the trees around us soak up during photosynthesis. As atmospheric CO2 increases, some of it actually dissolves into surface waters. And you guessed it, a huge source of surface water is our oceans. To see this in action, I'm going to add a few drops of bromothymol blue, or an indicator that changes color when the acidity changes within our cup. Warm colors mean more acidic. Remember how our lungs exhale CO2? Now, our oceans might not look any different, but even a small amount of above normal acidification has a huge impact on the critters that call oceans home. Especially carbonate-based ones low on the food chain, like mollusks, corals, and some types of plankton. I have some mollusk shells here. Maybe you have some too. If not, grab an eggshell or even some Tums. Yep, that's right. Tums are made of calcium carbonate too. That's why we take them when our stomachs are feeling extra spicy. Now, our oceans are not nearly as acidic as vinegar, even on a bad day. But remember, we're modeling this process and trying to speed it up. That way we can see the impact in this 3-minute video. Almost immediately after adding your shells to the vinegar, you can start to see bubbles forming. This is the calcium carbonate actually dissolving in the acid. Eventually, after an unfortunate night's sleep for the imaginary mollusks living inside of these shells, their home and protection have completely dissolved. This is happening right now to coral reefs and marine environments all over the planet, on a faster rate than these ecosystems can repair themselves. Our oceans do so much for our planet. They regulate the climate, they support almost 80% of life on Earth, and almost 60% of humans live on or near the coast. So I asked some of my friends, why are oceans important to them?
The ocean is important to me because the waves make me feel peaceful.
Hey Sami, my favorite vacation is to head to the beach and get to explore and hunt for seashells and for shark's teeth.
The ocean produces over half the world's oxygen, and it's beautiful.
And I love long walks on the beach. So let us know, why are oceans important to you? We'll see you next time when we get to amaze our brains together at home.